because to this version what we are going to use 46.0 is a standard version, as I said, and we are going to install 46.0 now, and this is a little bit standard version. I suggest you to use this version because of some small problems what we are facing, and we'll see. And we have to stop the updates also, as I said. How to stop the updates of this Firefox browser? Go to Tools, go to Options, go to Tools, go to Options, Tools, arrow mark Options, arrow mark Advanced. Here you will have something called Advanced, and go to Update, go to Update, and never check for updates. If you select this thing, select this option, right, when you restart your machine, it will not update to the latest version, so that it will stick to this version. Going further, you will not face any problem. Or else, if you install the Selenium IDE also, if it updates to the latest version, you will not able to see the Selenium IDE in the latest version. There is some problem with the mismatch of the version. Okay, just only today's class, take down the running notes, whatever I give. It's not much important of Selenium. Learning of Selenium IDE doesn't help you anywhere in the interview, as well as anywhere in the job also as well. Just to learn WebDriver, first this is the starting point. You want to learn what is meant by automation, what is the strategy of automation. That can be quickly learned by using this Selenium IDE. That's why we are learning this Selenium IDE. This is all how to stop the updates. Now, if you have those, if you are unable to see the green button or red button, if your UI is looking something wrong, or else if you are unable to install, that is all because of this version issues only. Uninstall the latest version, but make sure before uninstalling, stop the updates. Then uninstall, then install the 46.0 version. You will not face those problems. Okay, that's all about installation. Now we are going to see about this working with Selenium IDE. We'll just click on the Selenium IDE so that we'll get the Selenium IDE window. And whatever we do in the browser, that will get recorded here. Then we can run the same thing which gets recorded here. Right. Everyone uses this Gmail to log in. Gmail, Facebook, or Yahoo, or something. But we are going to see something, a real-time application that is nothing but demo.actitime.com. What is this application in the sense? I'll first. What is the username to log in into this? Admin, and password is manager, login. See, this application is used by many companies normally. This application is used for, it's a time track tracking application. What is this application? For example, if you are working in a company called TCS. In TCS, there might be many projects. In TCS, there might be many projects, and each and every project will have different login time and logout time. And all the employees working in the TCS will enter in the common gate and exit in a common gate. But HRs have to manage, monitor the time. For each and every employee, they cannot sit and calculate the time. They need some application which is very friendly so that they can calculate based on their working hours whether they are entering properly. That is all about this application. This application does that work. How it does all those things, we can see later. This is a time tracking application. This is used by many companies. Xerox, Accenture is the biggest client what we have. Yeah, Dell EMC also has joined recently. Accenture and Xerox is the biggest client. I mean, the more number of users. These are the companies what this application is using. HRs will be using that. Okay. It's a very good application, and actually this is not the actual version what we have given to them. This is some dummy version what I have installed here, because we should not give the exact application here because of some legal problem. But in this application, there are some flaws also. Wantedly, I have made some flaws in this. I mean, there are some bugs. Just when we are doing some testing, we want to know about that, how if bug arises, how to automate that, and all those things. Okay, now just we can come to know how to log in and how to log out as of now. We know how to log in and log out. Now what I am going to do is I am going to open Selenium IDE and just log in into this application. Open demo.actytime.com. Open demo.actytime.com. Yes, record will be by default, it will be on. By default, see, if you want, I'll do it from the beginning once again. Go to Tools, Selenium IDE. Normally, you have to check whether record is in on or not. Yes, check it. By default, it will be on only. Whatever you do here now, that will get recorded. Demo.actytime.com. Then what is the next step? Enter admin. It is getting recorded. Enter manager. Look here, it is getting recorded. Then if I click on login, it will get recorded again. Now if I stop recording, I have stopped recording. And if I click on logout, will it record this logout? No, because I have stopped recording. Now let me run this. Let me run this whatever I had run by using this button is used to run. Click on this, it will run. It will open the browser, enter admin. It is doing very quickly. I am unable to see the speed of execution also, right? Suddenly it has entered admin and manager and it has clicked on login because I've kept this mode in very fast mode. By default, it will be in fast mode. Running will be in very fast mode. Slow down the speed of execution and try to run this. Now, let me run this once again. Run this. demo.actytime.com, enter admin, enter manager, click on login. It has logged in into the application. Now I have recorded the login scenario here. Yes, right? Now this is one test case. Am I correct? This is one test case, login test case. This is a login test case. Save this test case. I am going to save this test case. If you are not stopping recording and if you run also, by default it will stop and it will run. If you are not stopping and running, it will when you run this automatically, record will get stopped. No, permanently it will stop. Save test case. Go to batch class. Batch 108. I will name this as login. Save this test case. I have saved this test case as login. Okay. I have closed this. I will go home today and I will come back tomorrow again and I will open this Selenium IDE. Yesterday I have recorded one test case and kept ready, right? I can open the test case. Go to file, open this login test case. It has opened. Slow down the speed of execution. Then start running this. It will open demo.actytime.com. Enter admin, manager, click on login. A small sort of login has been, automated. And I have saved the test case and I am using that again. Like this, whatever you have, you can record and keep it, save it and keep it with you. And you can run it so that it will save some time, right? Okay. But normally, no one will encourage record and playback. It is not suggested to use that. Why? In the sense, we will learn it after learning the coding here. Have you understood this? Just take down how to record and how to playback. Just take down in your notes how to record and how to playback the test case so that you can record a test case and you can playback the test case and you can check once. How to record and playback a test case in Selenium IDE. చెప్పమో తెల్లారితో పోయి పింగ్ చేస్తున్నావు, ఊరికే చేసావా? ఓకే ఓకే సరే మేడం, నేను క్లాస్లో ఉన్నా. ఓకే నెక్స్ట్ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు సీ ఫ్యూ మోర్ టెస్ట్ కేస్, హౌ టు రికార్డ్ ఫ్యూ మోర్ టెస్ట్ కేస్ అండ్ హౌ టు వర్క్ విత్ దిస్ అండ్ సీ వాట్ ఆర్ ద కామన్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ వాట్ వీ విల్ బి ఫేసింగ్. నౌ ఐ హావ్ జస్ట్ రికార్డెడ్ లాగిన్ ఓన్లీ, రైట్? I have just recorded only login. Now, let me record a complete cycle. Login and logout is a complete cycle for login test case, right? Let's do that. Start recording. Open demo.act, open demo.actytime.com. Open demo.actytime.com. Enter admin, manager. Click on login. Click on login. After logging in, I want to log out of the application. After logging in, I have logged out of the application. It has logged out also. Now save this test case. Go to file, save test case. I'll save this test case as login logout. Login logout. Login logout. Now I have slowed down the speed of execution also, and if I run it has opened demo.actytime.com, enter admin, manager, click on login, and it is showing error here, right? It is showing a red color error here. Why? What is the reason? Can you guess why? Why it is not found? No, after logging in only it is looking for logout. Not before looking, sorry, not before login. Why? Because this steps will execute one after the other continuously without any time gap. But after logging in, it is taking some time to load the page there. In the meantime itself, it is coming and searching for this logout link. It cannot find that logout link there suddenly, right? It takes some time. In between this login and logout, you need to wait for some time, or else it will throw you an error. These are the common problems what you will be facing when you are recording and playing back. So that what you have to do here, you have to wait for some time. When I have to wait? After login, I need to wait for some time. So that in between this login and logout, you need to wait for some. Here, it has used click login button. It has used click login button, right? Just I will log out of this. Now if I run this particular test case, you will be getting an error, because after logging, in between login and logout, I need to wait for some time. So that click, single click on this login statement, come and edit the statement here. In the command, come and edit the statement, click and wait. So that what it does, after clicking on login, it will wait for some time. It will wait for 30 seconds there. But it will not wait completely the 30 seconds. It will wait till the page gets loaded. But it will wait for a maximum of 30 seconds. Even though if the page doesn't load in 30 seconds, then there is some problem with connectivity or internet or something. That's why it will throw you an error here. Okay. Have you understood this? Now, if I run this, it will not get any error now. Open demo.actytime.com, enter admin, manager, click on login. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 seconds it has loaded. The 6th second it has clicked on logout and it has came out. Automatically it will synchronize. That synchronization is there. Sir, my internet is very slow. I want to change the time for 60 seconds. You can change that. How to change that also, I will let you know now. Have you understood this? You have to understand the difference between click and click and wait. What does click does? As soon as it clicks, it comes to the next line of execution. But click and wait will wait for the page to be loaded. It will wait for about 30 seconds. Just take down the heading. Just take down as difference between click and wait. Just a minute. I'll come back.
Okay, next.
Raji, Harsha and Joshna, are you able to hear me clearly? Any problem? Okay, fine. Thank you. Next. We are seeing recording and playing back the test cases here. And the common problems, what? Normally, when Selenium is there initially, right? They will not be recording and playing back. They will be writing the test case. We want to know how to write this test case. How to write this test cases here. Before that. Next, I am going to start writing the test case. Go to new test case. I am going to start writing the test case here. The same login test case I will write. But before writing that, we can see this. I have a web page called xyz.com. I have username, password and I have login button. If I want to log in, first I need to open the browser. Then I need to open the URL. Then I want to enter the username. Where I want to enter the username? In the username text box. Enter the password in the password box. Then click on login button. These are the steps what you will be. After opening the browser and URL, if I want to enter the username in the username text box, first I need to identify the username text box, then perform some typing operation. Identify the password box, then perform some typing operation. Identify the login button and perform some click operation. To do any automation activity, what are the two steps what we will be following? Identify the element and perform action on it. These are the two steps what we will be. To identify the elements, what is the technique what we will be using? We will be using element locators to identify the element. Element locators to identify the element. In Selenium, there are 8 element locators. Very, very, very important interview question. See, daily throughout our class, daily I'll be giving one or two interview questions. Finally, you will end up with nearly 50 interview questions. Okay, last some 3 to 4 pages of your notebook allocate for interview questions. I'll start giving the interview questions. First question, what is the difference between QTP and Selenium? What is the difference between QTP and Selenium? It will be around 50 questions will be there. Based on that, you allocate your notes and you start. What is the difference between Selenium and QTP? Second, how many element locators are there and what are they? How many element locators are there? 8. What are they? ID, name, link text. Take down this. Link text. Follow the order also. Don't miss this order also, whatever I am giving. ID, name, link text, XPath, CSS selector, class name, tag name, and partial link text. These are the 8 element locators available in Selenium. Very, very important. These are the 8 element locators. Take them. Class name, tag name and partial link text. ID, name, link text, XPath. Slowly we will keep on using, you will remember that, you no need to by heart. Don't by heart even a single piece of code here or anything. Just you have to understand each and everything here. You should never ever by heart. By hearting will never help you to solve the problems. Okay, now we are in the process of recording and playing back the test cases, right? First we have recorded and played the test case, then we have logged in and logged out, then we have faced some error between the timing problem there. It will take some time, that's why we have used click and wait instead of click. That issue is sorted. Now when I use this, I said by default it will take 30 seconds, right? But if your internet is slow, what to do? I said that I will be telling, but I forgot to tell. Now I will tell you how to do. Change the time. If you want to change the time, default timeout value, that is the default timeout value, right? If you want to change this default timeout value, go to options. In this Selenium IDE, you will be having a tab called options. Go to options. Go to options again. In this, you will find an option called options. Go to this options. Here it is given as 30,000 milliseconds. Default timeout value as 30,000 milliseconds. Change this to 60,000 milliseconds if you want to change it for 1 minute, however the time you want, and then click on OK, so that it will wait for the amount of time what you have given there, maximum. But if the page loads in 1 or 2 seconds, it will automatically come to the next line of execution. Here you are giving the maximum time limit in options, options, and change the default timeout value. Take down how to change the default timeout value in Selenium IDE. How to change the default timeout value in Selenium IDE. Earlier, before some 7 to 8 years, we used to get these kind of questions, but now you will not be getting this because no one uses the Selenium IDE anywhere. How to change the default timeout value in Selenium IDE? Go to options, options, and change the default timeout value. Change the default timeout value. Now, until now we are recording and playing back the test case, right? Next step, I am going to write the test case by myself here. I am going to write the test case by myself. How? I have opened a new test case. What is the first step what I have to do? Open the browser. For this Selenium IDE, we cannot open the browser here through coding. We should open the browser and do the other actions. That is nothing but first I need to open the URL. I need to open demo.actitime.com. Single click here. Single click on the statement, the empty statement here. Come and write the command. Write the command as open is the command. Open is the command. Click on this open. And in the base URL, give the URL on which you are going to work. This is the URL which you are going to work, right? Give the URL on which you are going to work. That's it. It will open the URL. It will open the now if I run this, it will open the URL. Okay, if you want this extension URL also, I mean this login.do also, you can paste that here, or else just leave it also, not a problem. This is how to open the URL. Open is the command to open the URL. Open and in the base URL put the URL. It will open the URL. Next step, what is the next step what you will be doing? Enter the username. Where to enter the username? Browser name text box. Username text box. In the username text box. First, if I want to type something here, what is the first step what I have to do? I need to identify this element. How to identify the element? By using element locators. There are 8 element locators. To identify the element, I want to do right click, inspect element with Firebug. Right click and inspect element with Firebug. Click on this. This is the source code of that element. This is the source code. Whatever it is highlighted in the blue. This is the source code of that element. Any element, see when I mouse over on this, it is highlighting that particular element. When I mouse over here, right click, inspect element with Firebug, you will get the source code of this element. Any element is built with tag name. Input is the tag name. Input is the tag name. Anything which comes next to the open angular brace is the tag name. this element is built with input as a tag name. Each and every element will have multiple attributes with their attribute values. ID equal to username is one attribute and attribute value. ID is equal to username is one attribute and attribute value. Class equal to text field. Class equal to text field is one attribute and attribute value. Type equal to text is one attribute and attribute value. Value equal to null. Value equal to null is there, right? This is one attribute and attribute value. Name equal to username is one attribute and attribute value. Like this, each and every element will have multiple set of attributes and attribute values. That is how normally an element will be built. Have you understood how these elements are built? With a tag name and set of attributes and attribute values. You no need to worry about what is the tag name and all. Because we are not developers, we are testers. Okay. Now this element is built with input. With what are the attributes does this element has? Input is not an attribute, that is the tag name. What are the attributes does this has? ID, class, type. Type, value, name, and placeholder. Each and every attribute is having an attribute value also. Have you understood what is attribute and attribute value here? Now, do you have ID attribute here? Yes. ID equal to username. What is the first element locator? ID. If you have ID for that element, you can use ID directly. And that ID equal to username, you are going to do some typing operation and enter admin there. That is what you are going to do, right? Now, as a first step, I have opened the browser. Opened the URL. That is done. Next step, I want to type something in that ID equal to username. Right? In the command, give type. In the target where you are going to type? ID equal to username. And value. If you are typing here, you will be getting that here. Okay? Value, what you are going to type? Admin. That's it. Now, if you double click on the statement, only this statement will get executed. Single click is used to edit the statement. Double click is used to execute that statement. Now, I am going to do double click. It has executed there. Are you understanding this? Identify the element, perform action. Identify the element, perform action. Now I am using some Selenium IDE code how to write. Going further, I will be using some Java code to perform the action on that ID equal to username. That is nothing but your web driver program. Okay, next. I have finished this step. What is the next step?
Password.
I want to enter password. Where I want to enter?
In the password
box. Now what you do, identify this password box. How will you identify? Right click. Inspect element with Firebug. What are the attributes does this element has?
Class.
Type. Class equal to text field, password field is one attribute. This is one attribute. Class. Type. Value. Name. Placeholder. Do you have ID attribute there? What if you don't have ID, what is the next element locator what you will be using?
Name.
Do you have name attribute here?
Yes,
it is there. Name equal to PWD. What is this? Name equal to PWD. That is the element locator. If you don't have ID, go for name. If you have ID, use ID. Or else go for name. How to work? Most of the elements in real time will not have ID and name. Don't worry about that. We'll see that. Okay. Don't think that every element will have ID and name. We can 90% of the elements will not have. Okay, how to overcome that we will see later. That is the element locators topic what we are going to learn. Okay, now in this case I cannot use ID. I can use name equal to PWD. Now can you tell me how to do that? Single click here. Come and give the command. What is the command?
Type.
What is the target?
Name
equal to PWD. And what is the value?
Manager.
That's it. Done. Now if I double click on this, this gets executed. Next I want to click on this login button. First identify the element locator of this element. identify the element locator. Right click, inspect element with Firebug. Which element locator I can use here?
ID.
ID, because I have ID. Okay, if you have ID directly, you can take ID. I can use ID. Now, what is the command what I have to use? Click. If possible, it is better to use click and wait than using click, so that it will click and wait for the amount of 30 seconds there, so that it will log in. Okay. Now, if I double click on this, it will log in into that application. Are you understanding how recording will happen at the background? This is how recording happens. Now, we know some basics about element locators also, how to identify ID, name, all those things. This is how recording and playback will happen at your background. Okay. Now, in yesterday's class, I said I will be giving you the course content today. You can take down the course content. Going further, we will follow this course content also as well. Take down in the first page of your notebook, you can take down this course content as well. 38 topics are there. This is one more topic, extra topic added in between. Today we have saw about, yesterday we have saw basics of testing and automation. Today we have saw Selenium ID. That's it. Today's topic will be done. Few topics I will finish in 10 to 15 minutes. Few topics it will take 3 to 4 days, 5 days also, like that. Okay. See, something like drag and drop, this topic I will complete in just 15 minutes. But Java topics I will take 4 to 5 days also. Starting with basics of Java, not complete Java. In between I will keep on teaching Java topics again. When I am teaching these topics also. This is some outsketch, not the complete syllabus. I am giving outsketch of each and every day's topic here. Yes. Oops concepts is more than sufficient here to learn Selenium. No need to learn advanced topics and all. Dictionary. I will let you know. You no need to worry about the Java topics also. Class, objects, all these things I will let you know very clearly. After finishing our Java topics, you can ask whatever the doubts you have in your Java. I have not started yet. I will be starting on next Thursday or Friday. Before that, we have some other prerequisites to learn. We want to know what is element locators completely. Then only we can start performing the action. When we are going to perform action only, we want to know about the Java. Before performing the action, we will learn about Java, then we will enter into performing action. That is the procedure. Normally, most of the people, those who learn, right, they will directly jump into learning Java and start learning Selenium. Finally, they keep on struggling in learning. Why? Because they will not know the prerequisites. Difference between click and wait. It's just nothing but click is nothing but it will click and next second it will go to the next line of execution. No, no. Selenium ID you will not get even a single question in interview. I am sure for that. No company will ask you because it has outdated before some 7 to 8 years. No, write in your notebook so that this is the index of your notebook. Prepare a complete booklet. After I complete each and every topic, just tick on the topic so that if I miss one or two topics also, you can remind me. Sir, you have missed the topic. Why can't you teach that? Okay. Your internet will be too fast. As soon as it clicks on login, the page might be getting open. If you have 100 Mbps speed, that will... Sometimes, while it is recording itself, it will click on click and wait. That will happen sometime. If you are very slow, if you are too lazy, right? Slowly, if you are clicking on the button, it will record as click and wait. See, here you can see that when I have recorded that. Just a minute, guys. See, when I have recorded this, click clicking on login button, it has recorded as click. But when it has clicked on logout link, it has recorded as click and wait. I didn't change the statement at all. By default, it has recorded as click. Sometimes it will record as click and wait also. It would have recorded click and wait. This is the outsketch. This is not the complete syllabus. Once we start each and every topic, in detail we will learn about this. Subtopics in each and every topic again. Just a minute. And this.